Purdue Boilermakers, the quarterback core has had the likes of Dawson, Greasy, and Phipps, Danielson, Herman, Everett, and a fella named Breeze, who's torn up the Big Ten and school record books, leading Purdue to its second Rose Bowl game ever. The Huskies just as notable with a quarterback legion of Heinrich, Lorette, Six Killer, and Moon, Chandler, Brunel, and the Heward brothers, and the big fella they call Tui, who has taken virtually all the quarterback snaps across the last two seasons, leading the Huskies to a co-championship in the Pac-10. So it's a Texas gunslinger from Indiana, a Samoan prince from the Pacific Northwest, center stage in the Rose Bowl, presented by AT&T. And here come the Washington Huskies, the Pac-10 champions. A record of 10-1, ranked fourth in the BCS poll. 14th trip to the Rose Bowl. Their record is even at 6-6-1. Head coach Rick Neuheisel, second year. Here are the Boilermakers. Their first time in the Rose Bowl since 1967. Their record 8-3. Head coach Joe Tiller, his fourth year. He has taken Purdue to four straight bowl games. Times have you heard the magic in life is to find the right place at the right time? Number 15 did it perfectly. He went to Purdue to be a quarterback under Joe Tiller. Here's how he explained it happened.
Coach Tiller getting that job and calling me up in December of my senior year. I had not gotten a call from any school up to that point, and he said, "Hey, you want to come be my quarterback?" And I thought, well, that's a long way away from home, but I like your offense, I like you, I like the school, I like the conference. What the heck?
And now to the center of the field for the flip of the coin as Joe Tiller settles in for an afternoon of hard work. The referee today out of the Atlantic Coast Conference is Jack Childress.
And the Washington first off, Mr. Ward, Mr. Sopo, and Mr. Mr. Breeze, Mr. Botts, and we also have an honorary captain from the University of Washington, number 25, who is in the press box, Curtis Williams. Gentlemen, shake hands, please.
God bless you.
And gentlemen from Washington, captains, I would like to introduce the dignitaries for today's program. First off, Mr. Warren Brown, who is the president of the Tournament of Roses. Gentlemen, please meet Mr. Brown. Grand Marshal, Mr. Tom Brokaw. He's the Grand Marshal of the Tournament of Roses.
Play well.
Shake hands, gentlemen.
Great game. Play well.
Gentlemen, we have a coin that Mr. Brokaw will toss. If you can please come in where you can hear me. This coin, there'll be no need to toss this. Washington, you're in blue. You're the home team. Purdue, you're in white. You're the visiting team. But this coin has a W for Washington. On the other side, it has the logo for the Purdue Boilermakers, the train. Mr. Brokaw will toss this. There's no need to call it. However it comes up, that team will win the toss. If it is, let it land. If it comes up sideways, gentlemen, we'll do it over. Mr. Brokaw. It is Washington. You gentlemen have won the toss. It will be your choice. Washington coin is up, gentlemen. Washington, what would you prefer? You can receive, kick off, or defend a goal, or defer to the second half.
Defer.
Excuse me, gentlemen. Washington captain, I'm going to win the ball. Purdue captains, you want the ball. Which way would you gentlemen like to kick? Kick that way. Blue captains here, white captains here. Blue won the toss and deferred. Purdue's choice this half to receive again. Gentlemen, shake hands.
All right, Tim Brandt, now that we know who gets the ball first, what kind of offense can we expect from Messrs. Breeze and Tuiasa Sopo?
Well, you know they're quality people. They are warriors. They are extremely competitive, but they do it out of different schemes. Take a look
at how they utilize these quarterbacks on each side of this field. We'll start with Drew Brees of Purdue. Now, they will use four wide receivers, sometimes five, and spread that defense all the way across the field. Now, Brees will pump fake. Read those guys, bite the fake. He's already located his receiver, goes to that open area, that soft spot, great decision. Tui Asasopo, they like to get him on the corner, but watch his read. He reads that defensive end. His body lean is going for the pitch man. He takes him inside, first down Washington. Two distinctively different offensive schemes, but two terrific quarterbacks.
Let's talk about the resume of how these two teams got to this ball game and take a look at what the Boilermakers did. And I want you to pay particular attention to what happened in the month of October. That, to me, is remarkable. To beat Michigan, Northwestern, Wisconsin, and Ohio State all in a row and come from behind, way behind twice.
And more than anything else, Keith, it gave them a great deal of confidence. When they won those four ball games, they believed they could beat anybody in the nation.
Well, the Washington Huskies had some fourth quarter heroics, and well, they could have lost six ball games this year because they gave Miami their only loss of the year and Oregon State their only loss of the season, whereas they lost at Eugene to Oregon. But they had five fourth quarter comebacks that were remarkable.
Sure, and everybody's yelling down at Miami saying they ought to be playing for the national championship. Don't forget, Washington beat Miami.
All right, the colors old gold and black everywhere on this New Year's Day in Pasadena. Purdue says they could have sold 45,000. I think they sold more than that. They are here to cheer the Boilermakers. And we're ready to play football. Vinny Sutherland is waiting to receive it along with Chris Clopton, and John Anderson kicks it off for the Washington Huskies. It's a very high kick looking up into a bright sky. Vinny Sutherland at the 14-yard line, and he'll come up short of the 20 on the return. So the AT&T starting lineup for the Purdue Boilermakers now. Quarterback Drew Brees, surely the right man in the right system as he's rung up record after record. He has also this year run for more yards than Marcus Tui Asasopo has. The backs and receivers, tailback is a stocky guy. And he's from Texas, as is Drew Brees. Now, Purdue's got a lot of folks from Texas on this football team, and you're going to hear Texas ringing out as the day goes along. But it's first down just short of the 20-yard line on the first snap for the white-shirted Boilermakers. And Drew Brees rolls, slips, and falls. Feet go out from under him back on the 15-yard line. So there's a loss on the play. Back inside the 15 at the 11 is where they'll put it. Now, we told you the tailback is a stocky sophomore, Montrell Lowe from Texas. He can burn a hole. Vinny Sutherland's not too big, neither is Seth Morales, but very good. It's a pitch and catch offense. The offensive front, remarkable performance in protecting their quarterback, and they are more than pushers. These guys can run block, and the left tackle, Matt Light, is an All-American. So now the Boilermakers start out in the hole after the feet went out from under their quarterback. They force him to run now as he pulls and throws to the sidelines. Throws about the original line of scrimmage. A.T. Simpson, a junior out of Indianapolis, made the catch for them. And he is up across the 25 to near the 27-28. So he's a little bit short of the first down.
Keith, this is a wide open, fun offense. It's basketball on grass. Football's flying all over the place again. It's critical today, the time of possession, to move the chains, get first downs. This is a great scramble by Brees, and all of a sudden he locates his man who's wide open. They've got a shot at the first here. Don't make it. Good close by Washington, and they'll be running to the football aggressively this afternoon.
But it gives you an idea of what the Husky secondary and are looking at for the rest of the afternoon. Brees, again, rolls out. Again, it's light protecting, and they force him wide. He's looking. Nothing there. He tries to run the ball, and he stepped out of bounds just short of the 25-yard line as the Huskies put him on his back, and the Boilermakers are going to have to put the ball in the air with the foot.
It's a great lick by Anthony Kelly, who's starting in front of Williams at that outside linebacker spot. He had a shot at Brees. He took it, put him on his back. He's going to say, hey, we're going to be coming after you all day. We want Brees to have his head on a swivel and looking for us.
In the punt now is Scott Kurz. K-U-R-Z is his name. Toure Butler is waiting for the Huskies, standing back inside his 40 at about the 42.
Washington's going to have good field position.
Snap was high. The kick is away, and it's a good one. It's a high-hanging spiral that is caught by Butler, and he is put away quickly, but too quickly, by Kenny Sutherland. There'll be a flag on it, and it'll cost Purdue 5 yards.
Jumped into the halo. He's got to stay outside the 2-yard circle, and all of a sudden he was in there, didn't give him enough room. That'll cost him. You know, it's still, this serves a purpose. Washington will have great field position, but again, you get a great lick like that early, and it really gets their attention. Listen to it. That's football, smash-mouth football.
Well, it was also perhaps not a very good decision by Butler, because he could have lost the ball in that circumstance, because they were looking right down the barrel at him, and he certainly should have been able to see him and call a fair catch.
But you know, that's the purpose of that 2-yard halo. Even if he catches that ball, they're still supposed to give him room to make the catch and avoid the injury.
All right, here come the Huskies for their first snap. The ball is just beyond the 35-yard line. Tuiasosefo is collared a yard short of the line of scrimmage. At quarterback, you've got an old-fashioned kind of football player in the AT&T starting lineup for the Washington Huskies. You just show him the place and tell him the time, and he'll come wearing whatever you want. Marcus Tuiasosefo. He's a tough guy. He wills this team up and down the field.
And unlike Breeze, where they use the pass to set up the run, Washington will use the legs of Tuiasosefo. They'll use the run to set up his pass.
Second down, 11. Neither one of the quarterbacks getting a very dramatic start in this ball game. Tuiasosefo rolling out, pursuit coming, passes way to the sideline. It's caught, but didn't amount to much. Over on the sideline. So the backs and receivers now for the Huskies. They're beat up at these positions. Braxton Clemens starting at tailback. Rich Alexis and Willa Hurst will play with sore shoulders. Justin Robbins has a sore shoulder. Todd Elstrom a sore leg. The tight end, Jerry Stevens, is healthy. The offensive front, they're 5 300-pounders here. And they, I expect today, will try to pound away as the game wears on.
In third and long situations, Keith, with Washington, look for the tight end, Jeremy Stevens. He's 6'7". He's got an advantage in height, and Tuiasosefo has to put the ball high.
On third and 9, pressure. Tuiasosefo breaks the pressure, throws the ball downfield, and the pass is incomplete, but there's a penalty flag, and it's called against Chris Clopton, a 5'7" cornerback trying to defend Justin Robbins, a 6-footer.
They look for Stevens. He was covered. They went deep. He was open for a second, but they now have to decide if that ball was catchable.
They apparently have decided.
Here's the scramble. He's looking right now for Stevens, but he's got a lot of pressure. He scrambles out as he does so well, finds the deep receiver. Was this ball catchable? I don't think so. But they ruled it was, and so they move him down.
It's a 15-yard penalty, remember, in college football, and a first down. Ball is on the Purdue side of the field for the first time today for Washington, in possession at the Boilermaker 48-yard line. Clemens, the tailback, runs into the pile and will get down to the 45-yard line. Defensively for the Purdue Boilermakers, it is a quick athletic group. The tackles Terrell and Mitrione weigh in the 280s, and they are really active people. The linebackers, along with the safeties, make up the heart of the defense. You need to know that there are 5 freshmen in this defensive unit, but the season's over now. There are no more freshmen. Good size at safeties, but Chris Clopton, I told you, was only 5'7". Coaches say he's a pit bull, but he's still only 5'7".
Yeah, and speed is the biggest asset of this defense.
Second down and 8. Ball thrown to the sidelines. It is Jeremy Stevens, the tight end. Stevens is a 6'7", 255-pound sophomore out of Olympia. He's a very agile tight end, very quick for a guy that size.
He's a problem maker for the Boilermakers, and they know it. They're preparing, knowing that Stevens is going to have a big part in this game plan. Not only is he tall, he can run, and after he catches it, he can elude a lot of tacklers. That's good coverage and a good tackle, but he's going to cause some problems later.
Number 14, different number for a tight end. Nobody behind Tuiasosefo now, as Conniff comes out in motion. He catches the ball, too. Here it goes to the outside now. There are 2 men after him. Now he throws, and it's completed down the field to Pat Reddick, the junior out of Newberry Park, California, at the 20-yard line. So that's the agility of Tuiasosefo that makes you commit. then all of a sudden, bang, he's got a target.
You know, we've seen him so often, Keith. He's not the best passer in the conference. He's not the best runner, but definitely the most dangerous. They cannot keep him in the pocket. He feels the pressure again. It's almost instinctive. He rolls, and once he rolls, now they've got to be concerned with the run. When they come up, then you find your receiver. There he is, Riddick. He's got the first down. They move the chains. This offense scored 30 points 8 times this year.
It is first down from the 20-yard line on the Purdue side of the field for the Washington Huskies. Option play. It's the Beal left, and Tuliasa Sopo will go down to the 15-yard line. The first play of the ball game was called today by Peggy Watson. Peggy Watson, who was a longtime associate in the football department at Washington for Don James, for Jim Lambright, and for Rick Neuheisel. She passed away last Friday, but the first play was called for her.
And you know what it was, Keith? She loved to see the ball in Tuliasa Sopo's hands, get him on the corner. And that's exactly what they ran, the same play we showed you in the open, and he ran it well.
They called it peg left, peg right. And it was a good call, Peg. May you humor live forever. Handed over the left side to Pat Conniff, the fullback. Hangs in there, got a yard, maybe a yard and a half. And now across the field, you've got a flag.
Take a look at the Dell Game Solutions for Washington. We mentioned time of possession is critical. They want to keep Ruiz off the field, so they want to shorten the game, melt the clock, move the chains, and they're doing that right now. Tuliasa Sopo has to spread the wealth. He's doing that. He can't do it all himself. He has to get Stevens involved. He has to get Clement as running back and Alexis in the game. He's got to get everybody involved in their game plan.
That's an offside penalty.
By the defense, 5-yard penalty. That's a first down.
So that's it's a big mistake by the Boilermakers because it gives Washington a first down. It's going to put the football right on the 10-yard line, first and goal.
Keep in mind, Purdue has not been in the Rose Bowl since the 1960s. Right now, their hearts are pounding through their chest. They've got cotton mouth right now. They've got to adjust.
Last time they were here, Timmy, candy bars were a nickel and Frank was singing Strangers in the Night.
The point is, right now, they've got to settle down. They've got to take this first blow by Washington and settle down and get in their game plan and not panic.
Now let's see what this great big old offensive front can do for the Huskies. Conniff is the man moving. Tuliasa Sopo looking to throw. Passes away underneath to Stevens, the tight end. And Stevens battles his way to the goal line. The ball comes out, and they're going to say what?
He was down inside the one. His knee hit.
Well, an extra effort there, trying to fight his way into the end zone, almost cost him the football. There was a freshman safety, Stuart Schweigert, that laid a lick on him and almost took the ball away.
Keith, I've made the point twice, and I will throughout the day. This guy is the biggest threat outside of Tuliasa Sopo, and they're going to use him all day long. He's a great receiver. He gets upfield. He's a tight end who can run. He's 6'7". He got all the way down to the one. I just run Tuliasa Sopo on the quarterback sneak here and get the 6 on the board.
Willie Hurst is in the game, but he's cold. I would imagine Tui takes this one. Oh, he gave it away to Conniff, the fullback.
There's a flag.
And there's a flag. I don't know why you have to hand the ball off. They needed 4 inches.
I agree with you, but you know, that's a great story. That's Tuliasa Sopo giving it off to his boyhood friend, Pat Conniff. He wants to share the wealth.
They're calling the flag against Purdue, looks like. At least the Huskies are begging the case there.
Well, you can't get any closer to the goal line.
Gained 2 inches on the penalty.
Oh, what a great story he is. All those years, one winning season.
Offside, defense, half the distance to the goal, repeat second down.
He comes in and takes him to 4 straight bowls. Keith, that's already the 4th penalty against Purdue. That's nerves.
They know they've got to be aggressive in attack, though, because they're outsized.
Yeah, but emotion gets in the way of concentration.
Curry keeps it this time, pitches it outside, and touchdown. Braxton Clemens walked in. Well, it may not have been pretty, and it may not have been fancy, but it counts.
His timing is impeccable. He knows they're looking for him on the corner. He reads so well. His decision-making is so solid. He read that defensive end came to him. He pitched it to the pitch man who was wide open and just walked in.
Use about 4.5 minutes on that possession, too. 8 plays, 64 yards. 5'11" on that possession. John Anderson out of Boynton Beach, Florida, will try the point out of Cody Pickett's hole. It's up. It's good. And so the Washington Huskies strike here in the first quarter and stick it in the end zone in their first possession. football game as Anderson kicked it to him. He is not that big, 5'9", but he's thick, 194 pounds, and he, too, is from Florida.
Drew Brees getting ready to come on. He has looked very nervous to me. He needs to settle down. On the other hand, you mentioned Washington wasn't pretty, and yet Tui Asisopo, 4-for-4, 36 yards on that drive.
Here's the strength of Anderson's leg. Back into the end zone, 6-7 yards deep, and it'll come out to the 20. Here's the Husky defense now. Number 70, nose tackle Larry Triplett, is Purdue's biggest worry. He is a disruptor. He'll probably be double-teamed most of the day, and that opens opportunities for others. The linebackers play like defensive ends. Farms and Kelly are like arrows off the perimeter. Front seven are the key for the Huskies' defense. Secondary, well, any secondary against Drew Brees is going to have a long afternoon. These people can play, though. True freshman Carruthers replaced Curtis Williams at that free safety position.
You mentioned Larry Triplett. He is an outstanding player. He's going to try to line up as much as he can on Ian Allen. He thinks he can beat Allen, and so they'll slide him over that side of the center. Like right now. See him moving?
Yeah, he moved about a yard. Handled him all right. In fact, got a little daylight as the ball comes into the stack with Montrell Lowe from LaPorte, Texas. And Montrell finds a couple of yards. The temperature down on the field is warm. It's, well, probably in the 90s, right on the surface of the field. But as the afternoon goes on and the angle of the sun changes, it will cool off dramatically.
Keith, as you did those starting lineups, I can't help but think when Purdue plays well, the offensive line plays well. When the offensive line plays poorly, Purdue plays poorly. It's hard to believe all those passes. Brees was only sacked 7 times this whole year.
Second down and 8. Out of the shotgun, Brees very quickly. Boom, boom. Man's got it. He's got a first down. It is John Standiford, a freshman from Monrovia, Indiana. Here's a look at our Tostitos team comparison.
Pretty interesting team comparison, too. If you look by sacks, Washington's had 33 of them, and that's with Tui Asisopo being as mobile as he is. But here's what we were just talking about. Brees has been sacked only 7 times this year. All the Purdue quarterbacks only 8 times all year. To me, that is incredible.
The football has been moved just short of the 35, where it's a first down for the Boilermakers. The backup quarterback today, incidentally, is David Edgerton, a senior from Garden City, Kansas Community College. Brees working out of the shotgun. Very quick release. Fires his tight end. He voted the top tight end in the country and got the Mackey Award. Tim Stratton, a junior from Oak Brook, Illinois, and another first down.
We talked a lot about Stevens on the other side being 6'7". Stratton, as you mentioned, the John Mackey Award winner.
Here's the penalty, Tim.
Offsides by the defense. That penalty is refused. First down.
But the point I was going to make is Stratton also figures big in the game plan. He is the guy that is 6'4", 252 pounds. He got everybody to jump. They flexed him out to the right, and he makes the catch. He's extremely smart finding the soft, open area.
The wild man to the team, too. He's the fun maker on that football team. From the 41-yard line of Washington, Brees getting pressure sacked. Well, that's 8. So the Huskies penetrate. Darryl Daniels, inside linebacker. You get involved or start double-teaming Triplett now. That's going to open the door for Daniels and Madavi, and Daniels came walking right through it.
Well, just as we tell you that he's only been sacked 7 times all year, here they come, and they bring it right up the middle. They try to overload. Look at this. They run a little quick stunt. Here comes Daniels, 24, finds the open area and makes the sack. They call him Double D, as you mentioned, but here's the deal. Rick Neuheisel calls him the piano guy. Says he runs like he's got a piano on his back. He's not fast, but he's smart, and he's aggressive.
Second down and 16 now for Purdue. Working out of the shotgun. Brees hands the ball off. Penalty flag was thrown. The play goes to the right side with low carrying. And he might have teased the Huskies into the neutral zone. Yeah, he did. Let me give the officials. They're from the Atlantic Coast Conference. Jack Childress, we told you, the referee, Rosario Amato, the umpire, Bud Elliott, the head linesman, Ted Jackson, the line judge, Daryl Harrison, the side judge, John Armstrong, the field judge, Virgil Valdez, the back judge, and Ron Cherry is your alternate. Go from one coast to the other, they have come.
Here's the difference right there. 4 penalties, 25 yards.
It's second down, 11 now for Purdue. gives the ball back to Lowe, and the Huskies eat him up right on the 45-yard line. When we finish up here in Pasadena today, it'll be Oregon State and Notre Dame in the first ever meeting of these two schools, the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl, right after the opening game of the Bowl Championship Series, which is this one, the Rose Bowl. I think that'll be a terrific football game over at the Fiesta Bowl. We've seen both teams, and Notre Dame would make many mistakes. Oregon State is a full bore, wide open, let her rip football team. Drew Brees with time, looking around, going big. He's got a man in the corner. It's incomplete, overthrew him. Seth Morales, a sophomore from Indianapolis, running under the ball.
Tell you what's pretty interesting, that Washington that time went to a zone blitz and got everybody back and had two guys that were playing free in the back of that zone. 14, 15 guys in the huddle. They're substituting from the field. You'll see when they run it, you'll see 41 drop out of there. He was up at the line of scrimmage. They're in that zone blitz. He throws it out of bounds. Good defense.
The receiver's
confused
running
him
out of bounds anyway. He had disqualified himself by running out of bounds for about 12 yards.
That's correct.
High snap over the head of the punter. Goes back and covers the ball at the 25-yard line. Tim Stratton snapped it, and the ball went sailing over the punter's head. Travis Dortch is the place kicker, and the punter is Scott Kurtz. And Kurtz, that chance, couldn't handle it. It was just too high. If it had been Dortch, the place kicker, he's 6'6". He'd have made the catch. So Purdue makes another mistake. And we've got a timeout in the first quarter at the Rose Bowl with the Huskies leading 7-0. Boilermakers.
Keith, you were asking me if it's the heat, if it's sweat. It's not. You can see he's got a good grip on the ball. That's the adrenaline flow he's got right now. He's too pumped up. Right now, Purdue has to settle down. They're making mistakes like this. All that is nerves, adrenaline, too much strength. It had nothing to do with sweat. You can see the grip he had on the ball, but they've got to settle down.
Well, they put the Washington Huskies in position to make their mountain a little higher, I'll tell you, because at the 25-yard line, first down, and Drew Brees on the sidelines and on the phone.
There's the big guy, Stevens.
He drops straight back. Heat's coming. Gets it away, and it is incomplete. He threw it away. Once you get outside the tackle in college football, you can throw the ball in the seats if you want to.
You know, that's a good point. You look at both of these guys, Keith, and you and I talked about this at great length this whole week. Brees and Tui Asisopo are probably two of the most cerebral quarterbacks you'll ever find. They study the game, they're students of the game, they know the rules, and they utilize the rules. That's certainly one they both know. They will not take sacks if they can help it.
Second down and 10 from the Boilermaker 25-yard line. Nobody behind him. Up the middle he goes. He's a big guy down to the 5-yard line, first and goal. He puts Stuart Swigert, the safety, on his back. And he's got a first and goal at the 5.
Every guy on that offensive line outweighs the Purdue defensive line by 40 pounds. Now watch the push off this line of scrimmage as soon as the ball is snapped. There's the trap. There's the play. It's a counter, actually. He cuts out behind the guard and makes a great play out of it. It's a very nice job up front by the 300-pound Frays and the 335-pound Ward to open that hole.
Tuiasa Sopo keeps it. Touchdown. He's warming up. That's his shoe that he's carrying as he goes to the bench looking for some change. Now here's John Anderson trying to make it 14-0. And 42 seconds remaining in the first quarter of play. The Washington Huskies lead Purdue by a score of 14-0. Bowl game in Pasadena. John Anderson kicking off now for the Washington Huskies. Purdue has Vinny Sutherland and Chris Clupton. The team people, 14 and 23, respectively. That's Clupton right there. And here's Mr. Anderson. He's going to drop this one a yard short of the end zone to Clupton. Pass. Burner. Penalty flag. Clupton tackled at about the 35, 36-yard line, but the flag was thrown back around the 20. And I do believe it came from the referee, Mr. Jones. Purdue's one mistake after another so far. That's a holding call against the Boilermakers.
Keith, let's take another look at the touchdown, because Washington is breaking tendencies. Down tight like this goal line, they give it to the fullback 9 times out of 10. But here's your fake, and everybody knows the tendencies, so they're going after Conniff. Look at the fake now, and look at the read by Tuiasa Sopo. Again, he reads the body lean of the defensive players. He cuts it up. Great touchdown. Loses a shoe in the end zone. But Tuiasa Sopo again making terrific decisions.
And the holding call against the Boilermakers put them back on their own 10-yard line. Advantage of it. This is Montrell Lowe trying to find some room, and he comes out to about the 15-yard line.
Keith, take a look at the Dell Game Solutions for Purdue. They too want to move the chains and melt the clock and keep it away from Tuiasa Sopo, but they've run 12 plays, and 5 of those have been for negative yardage. Keep Triplett off Breeze. They're going to try to double-team him. We've already seen Triplett moving over to get over Allen because he thinks he can beat him. They have to double-team him and keep him off. They also ran that blitz with double D Daniels, and he got a sack.
Well, Purdue's offense has run at what I guess you'd call 4 levels. Is that what the phraseology they put on it? Ball is pitched back to low. They're looking to run the ball a little bit, and they can run the ball. I told you that this offensive line is not just a bunch of pass blockers. They'll get out there and swap paint with you. And they did it just there as they put the ball up to the 30-yard line.
And they set up the run with the pass. Breeze came out firing today, not very effectively, but now they've loosened it up. They've taken some of the defenders out of the box, and so now they're going to let Lowe do it. He's a hard guy to get a hold of because he's only 5'7 and a half. He ran for 200 yards against Indiana. He's got tremendous speed, low center of gravity, very tough to tackle.
They pulled their big old Brandon Gorin back there, 304-pound tackle, and he got out in front as the lead block. Opened the door for him. Here comes Lowe again, and he's got good yardage on that play. Picked up about 8 on that carry. Hakeem Akbar making the tackle. Today's aerial coverage being provided by AT&T at the Rose Bowl.
You know, when you have a little guy like Lowe, Keith, I call him a hide-and-seek runner because he hides behind those big guys on that offensive line and seeks his hole before the defenders can locate him. He's so short, they can't find him.
A.T. Simpson comes into the ball game. He's caught 1 ball today, 2nd down and long 2. Lowe, it's his series, and he's hit right at the marker by Akbar. Akbar just nailed him, and you've got a penalty flag.
Going to be holding against Purdue again, so the Boilermakers will hurt themselves once they had 2nd and short. Every time they get in a decent situation, they hurt themselves.
Yep. Akbar, Hakeem was the roommate of Curtis Williams, the free safety of the Huskies, who suffered crippling injury in the Stanford ball game. But he is watching. He is here at the Rose Bowl, and he is watching the game. And he's just thrilled to be here, and his teammates are even more thrilled to have him here. And I can think you can expect to see Mr. Akbar have a pretty good day. Spot of the foul penalty. 2-yard gain, 10-yard penalty. 2nd down and 10 coming up.
People looking at the score and watching what's taking place here in the first quarter will say, hey, you know, Washington might blow him out. I don't think that's going to happen. I think from everything that's happened so far, I think it's going to be a very high-scoring game, and Purdue's going to be in it, really in it, by the fourth quarter.
Well, they almost got him down there. That's the 2nd time they've sacked him. Anthony Kelly and Jamon Willis were the 2 men who did it. And And they take him down back on the 24-yard line.
Keith, we've seen a lot of different blitzes out of Washington already. They've had the zone blitz. Watch him come from this side now. And this is coming hard. They've got what it looks like man coverage outside. Here's the play fake. They come from the outside. They've got him located. And here's a guy that was sacked only 7 times all year. Washington had 33 sacks on the season. We showed you that earlier. They've got 2 already in the first quarter.
That's 473 snaps. Pressure still coming. And he gets it away. This time down the middle. The pass is caught by John Stendefor. Greg Carruthers made the tackle, and there's the quality of Drew Brees right there. That would be the fourth level, I believe, of their offense. He looked 1, he looked 2, he looked 3, and then hit 4.
Take a look at this. This is a freshman who's going to do this. You've got 2 receivers out here. He's reading them both, but he's looking right now for the post. He sees they're in a 2-deep, 5-under zone. Now they let him go. See that? They release him into the open area, and that's where Drew Brees finds him before he gets to the safety. Well thrown, well educated.
First down, 46-yard line, 30-yard kickoff on the play. Ball is handed off to Lowe again, and Montrell Lowe will go for 4 yards on the carry. ABC Sports is the home of the Bowl Championship Series. On Wednesday night, the undefeated Oklahoma Sooners and Florida State will get together for a little head knocking. The game will be for the national championship in the FedEx Orange Bowl, January 3rd, live at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC. Shadows now have reached the sideline where Purdue is located and will soon be going out onto the field. It's going to start cooling off. Ball is handed off again to Montrell Lowe. And Lowe, who's having a pretty good day, will go down to about the 43-yard line.
Purdue's offensive line now starting to pound. If they can get that big offensive line going, Purdue will jump back in this game in a hurry.
Time running out on the first quarter of play. The final 4 seconds ticking away. And at the end of 1, it's 14-0 Washington. ABC Sports coverage of the Rose Bowl presented by AT&T. Returns after this message and a word from our ABC station. One of the prettiest airplanes ever built, the Mustang. Oh, giving the thumbs to form one of those.
Partner, I have to tell you, there are so many planes in the area over this stadium, I don't know how they're controlling them all.
Well, you got congestion on the ground to the point of gridlock. Now we got it in the sky with commercial banners.
Unbelievable.
Purdue has been held scoreless in only 6 of 44 quarters this season. The Washington Huskies just did it. 14-0 as we go to the second quarter of play. On third down, they run it and they get it. Montrell Lowe, who slashes over the left side, picks up the first down for the Purdue Boilermakers, and they'll put the ball at the Washington 33-yard line.
You know, coming into this game, every time Drew Brees would scramble in his last 6 outings, he got 4 yards or more. They're containing it pretty well here, so it's a good change to go to Lowe. Now, look at this huddle by Washington. They are substituting on the field to the sidelines and not from the sidelines to the field. This time they only had 11 guys, but they've been putting 14, 15 guys in there and then running them off the field.
They'll change that rule, I bet you. On first down, the Boilermakers, Brees back, pumps once, looks left, goes right, ball's in the air, and out of bounds, incomplete. And a penalty flag. The flag is thrown over there where the defender was working against the would-be receiver.
But Keith, I say again, I'm not sure that ball was catchable. But again, they rule it was.
Yeah, they've called penalty against the Huskies on the holding call. It'll be a 15-yard penalty.
Take a look at the Nokia player comparison, and obviously Tui Asisopo has a brilliant first quarter and just got 2 scores on the board. Brees still trying to find his way a little bit. You look at what he's doing, completion and attempts, it looks pretty good, but he's been knocked down 4 times. You see the rush yards, Brees, 84 of them.
Well, that got Rick's attention. Ball's about 4 feet over his head. There's the pitch back to Lowe. He's having a big one. That's his 10th carry. Ball comes out.
It was out of bounds before Washington recovered it. As a matter of fact, I think that Purdue's going to pick up an extra yard by the flip of the ball.
Akbar is the man who hit him. Ball is fumbled forward, out of bounds. Daniels covered it, but he was out of bounds. That's 10 carries now for Lowe, and he's over 50 yards.
Here's the ruling, and they're exactly right. You cannot fumble this ball forward and gain yardage, and you'll see as soon as it comes out of his hand, boom. All right, now right there where he's down is where that ball is going to be marked. Spot of the fumble. Where that ball came out of his hands, spot of the fumble is where that ball is marked now.
13-yard line, and second down and five. Hands the ball to Lowe, and Lowe gets hit by Larry Triplett. And Triplett doesn't wrap him and hold him down, but he's going to lose a yard or so on the play because Larry Triplett is a big, strong man, 6'1", 295 pounds.
He was completely parallel with the ground, but he was on top of Triplett and never hit the ground. Watch this. He's got tremendously quick feet. Right here, it looks like he's down. Triplett goes down. He's on top of those guys, now gets his feet back. So he was never down. His feet go so fast, it's like he's tap dancing on a light bulb.
Third down and six. They go back to the shotgun. Reese throws underneath. Ball is caught by Standiford. And Standiford will get taken out of bounds at about the 6-yard line.
But he'll pick up the first down, Keith, so it'll be first and goal now for Purdue. They're starting to move. They're more in rhythm, more in sync, getting more confidence. Standiford, just a true freshman. How about this? He's a terrific basketball player, but this time last year, he's playing in high school in small crowds. Here he is now in the Rose Bowl in front of all these people and millions at home.
He hasn't even seen them yet. He's having enough trouble swallowing and catching the football.
Right.
Pretty good player, though.
He sure is. This is fun.
He got that big old tackle now as a lead blocker. Number 77 did a good job, too. He took his man down. Brandon Gorin decked one of the Huskies and opened the way for the running back Lowe.
You know, he thought once he got free and he found the hole, he thought he was in. But I want you to watch the hit that Akbar puts on him. He's coming out of a safety spot. He has him eyed, inside out. Tuck his tail, bam, and then put him on his back. Knocked him sideways instead of forward. Here's the hit again by Akbar. That is one heck of a lick. He's an all-Pac-10 safety.
Purdue backed up 5 yards on the penalty.
Here's the problem, though, Keith. With that hit, Akbar goes out now, and he's shaking up a little bit.
That's an illegal formation, and that came up in conversation between Rick Neuheisel and the referees before John Childers before the ball game. Owen Biddle comes in now, number 43, at the safety position, replacing Akbar. And Breeze turned. And Montrell Lowe runs right into Biddle, who had just come into the ball game, the sophomore out of Bellevue, and Biddle makes the tackle.
Montrell Lowe has to be careful with the football. We saw him lose it once. That time he was carrying it very dangerously low. He's got to tuck that thing away, put his fingers around the end of the ball, put it up against his body, and hold on to it. Now watch when he spins. Watch this ball way down here right now, and almost did lose it.
Yeah, he did. Well, he's got it again. Out there, almost taken away again, but he got away with it. And they've stopped him just short of the 5-yard line.
So it'll bring up third and goal, Keith. They've got to get out and use the width of the field here. They've got to get on the corner, give Drew Brees the option of passing or running, and stretch the defense a little bit.
Well, they send some wideouts onto the field now.
I'd go with the big guy, Tim Stratton, but they at least have to get on the corner and use the width of the field.
Where Stratton is. Well, he's lined up on the right side. He's flexed out about 3 yards.
15th play of this drive.
Coming back to the line of scrimmage now. Stratton's hovers down right alongside of Corey. He's not going out. He's blocking. The ball thrown to the end zone. Touchdown, Dennis Sutherland.
Boy, give Jim Chaney, the offensive coordinator, and Joe Tiller a lot of credit. things were getting tight in there. They kept running low. Washington closed down on them, so they come out, they spread the field sideline to sideline, create space. They created air so they could get a pass in, and Sutherland found the open crease.
The extra point try now from Travis Dorsch, who I believe is the tallest place kicker in the country at 6'6". And the kick is good. And the Boilermakers on the board. As we get started here in the second quarter of play, it's now 14-7 as they go 90 yards and 15 plays. 5 yards, and Drew Brees threw a bullet. Now time for the Aflac trivia question. Today's question, who kicked the winning extra point for Purdue in the 1967 Rose Bowl?
I know. I know. The last time they were here, huh?
Only another time.
Right.
I got a message from him this morning.
I know
it
you
It went
did.
Simply like this. Hail Purdue, hail Purdue, hail Purdue.
Keith, I don't know if you could hear anything that was going on in that sideline down there, but they are yelling at the offense, Purdue is, to get out of the huddle and up to the line quickly. They aren't giving Drew Brees enough time to audibleize to check in and out of things.
All right, Travis Dorsch will kick off. He's from Bozeman, Montana. Well, Joe Tiller, the coach, played over at Montana State in Bozeman, so there must have been some relationship there to get Dorsch from Bozeman over to West Lafayette.
I think Greg Carruthers is from Montana.
He's from Helena. Yeah.
Yeah. Montana, where the cattle outnumber the humans, 3-1.
High deep kick. Well, that's a good leg. Way back and gone. .11:26 to go in the first half of play. The Washington Huskies leading Purdue by a score of 14-7.
Didn't think I knew all about that cattle stuff.
There are pockets of pollution, though.
Oh, stop it.
All right, we've got a timeout at the Rose Bowl in Pasadena. Now the shadows start to reach onto the playing surface. What's a Boilermaker? What's a Boilermaker? Boilermaker is whatever you want him to be, as long as he goes to school at Purdue.
Jay Leno says, you got to love a school where the mascot it's a party drink.
They've had a good time out here. Louis Asisoko, a little drop off here. Pass to Willie Hurst. And Willie Hurst just gets smothered. And the Boilers pick up the ball and run away with it. But it's going to be called down. It's Gilbert Gardner, who is a freshman from Angleton, Texas, who made the tackle.
He came to Purdue as a receiver. Never played linebacker before this year. Actually was recruited as a wide receiver. But look what he does here. He comes up fast, closes inside out, doesn't give him anywhere to go, and makes a good, solid tackle.
And he's happy about it.
Well, and you can see and feel the momentum of the game changing a little bit as Purdue now has settled down, and now they're starting to play football.
And it's second down for the Huskies, and ball's back around the 14-yard line. Ball is thrown off the hands. That's the kind of a ball that is picked off. It was thrown for Todd Elstrom, and Elstrom could not get up and pull it down. Thrown hard and high, and turned into a tip. And you hold your breath on those.
Sure do. My daddy used to say, if it hits your hands, you better catch it. And I know that prior to the game, Rick Neuheisel was upset with all of his receivers because they weren't catching the ball. Woodyard had given him space to make the catch. It was high and hard. They got to go up and get those.
It's third down and officially a 15, though it's a little more than that. Crowd in that end zone, those are mostly Purdue folks, and they're trying to help their team. And Tui Asisoko back gets the pass away down the middle. It is to the tight end, Jeremy Stevens, and it's a first down up at the 36-yard line. Oh, he is a big target and a prime weapon. 21-yard pickup.
Anytime they flex you out like that and they spread the field, the inside receiver is the most dangerous. We told you about Stevens and his height. Now, here he is in here, and he's just going to come down the middle of that Purdue defense. He's got the most field to work with. Here he comes down the middle. Actually, circled the wrong guy. But he was the inside guy of the three receivers flexed from his tight end spot and found that middle seam.
He left the ball game right after that catch, and he was dragging a leg a little bit, but he was by himself. And here's a penalty flag. The ball is handed off to Willie Hurst. Flag is thrown to the linesman across the way, and Willie's out just over the 40 to the 41.
How could I circle the wrong guy. He's 6'7". Can't miss him. I'm the only guy in the stadium that missed him.
Offsides, Purdue.
I got so excited because I knew he was going to be the guy.
You've been out here in Pasadena too long. I'll send you back there where it's cold and the weather's, life is harsh.
I got to get you back there with
me. By the defense, 5 yards, previous spot. Repeat first down.
That is the eighth penalty, Tim, on Purdue. The 56 yards. That's hurting yourself.
It really is. And again, we said earlier, emotion gets in the way of concentration. They've got to be smarter. You don't mind aggressive, over-aggressive penalties occasionally. But when you're just making stupid mistakes, coaches will just go crazy.
First and five for the Huskies. All handed to Hurst. Well, they jump all over, will they? Let's spend a moment with Todd Harris on the field.
Well, Keith, Jeremy Stevens is coming back in. It looked like he had a helmet to the thigh, pointed to the train. They just did a quick massage on it. One other note, Aiken Adell on the Purdue side is yelling at his defensive players to watch the eyes of Marcus Tuiasosopo. He thinks if you watch Marcus's eyes, he will give away which way he's going to run on a run. But we've seen that all year, and the Pac-10, not many people have been successful in doing that. Keith?
What's the temperature down there now, Todd? It's cooled off?
Yeah, it's balmy 82. I think at game time it was closer to 90, but the folks at Purdue now enjoying the weather more typical to what they have. I know in West Lafayette it's 20 degrees right now.
Yeah, it was a high of 20-21 today. 50 in Seattle today. Here's Tuiasosopo pitching it wide. Won't work, folks. They were looking for it and they've timed it. Landon Johnson was in the right place at the right time. He's another Texan.
Aiken Adell might be on to something if Marcus is tipping things off. Adell is a smart player, 19 sacks in 2 years, so he knows how to read a quarterback's eyes.
So they have squandered that first and five circumstance as they go back to third down and 10.
Purdue is undersized up front. Substitutions are key. They've got to rotate them in that heat that you just talked about with Todd. But at the same time, they've got to use that quickness that they have, that advantage in quickness, to their advantage.
Hurst catches, but it's well short of the first down marker. He's taken down at about the 42-yard line. Landon Johnson again in on the play. Another freshman. There were five freshmen on that Purdue defensive lineup.
For this defense to be successful, everybody has to get into the mix here. They've got to pursue the football. You've got to get 11 hats around the football. And right now you're seeing Purdue really starting to get after things a little bit more.
This is the first punt for the Huskies today. Ryan Fleming, a senior out of Seattle, good punter coming out. He should hit the ball around the 31-yard line with Vinny Sullivan waiting for Purdue. Sutherland standing back at his 13.
He's a good punter.
Sutherland calls fair catch at the 19-yard line. And there Purdue will have it. First down, a 14-7 ball game, and right now it appears that Mo might be wearing white. 7:29 to play in the first half of the 87th Rose Bowl game presented by AT&T here on ABC Sports. The Purdue Boilermakers coming out now. Last time they had the football, they put it in the end zone. Breeze to Sutherland. They will start this possession from their own 19-yard line. This is Montrell Lowe, and he spins away for 4 yards. Fiesta Bowl, Tostitos Fiesta Bowl tonight over in Tempe. Next on ABC, home of the Bowl Championship Series, it's Oregon State and Notre Dame. The quarterbacks, Matt LaVecchio, freshman for Notre Dame. For Oregon State, Jonathan Smith. Second down and 6. Huskies almost got in that neutral zone. They may have. Montrell Lowe breaks the play and gets it out across the 30 for the first down. And it may well be it's an offside against Washington. They'll take the play.
Pretty interesting watching Drew Brees that time. He moves Stratton, his tight end, up on the line, making the strength of formation the right side. Everybody shifted
offside.
That way and ran the backside.
Defense, that penalty is declined. First down.
What's he doing? Changing his hard count? Or
well,
what?
First thing he did was change the formation. He brought his tight end up to the line of scrimmage, right? He's got him set now. He gives him the hard count. They were working it. this all week in practice because they thought Washington was so aggressive they could get him two or three times during the game. They just got him once.
Oh, man. You don't tell me they're not doing some hitting. Lowe's helmet comes flying off as Greg Carruthers laid a lick on him. They're getting serious now.
They are. You know, last year everybody talked about the Pac-10 being the poorest tackling conference and not being aggressive. Well, look at this. Tuck your tail, sky your eyes, drive right through his chin, and it knocked his helmet off. Carruthers is just a young guy, too, a freshman.
Jerry Claiborne teach you that?
That is a picture-perfect form tackle by Greg Carruthers, the freshman.
Second down and short six. Huskies are offside. They were in the neutral zone. They got a flag. The guy on this side was penetrated. The flag came from across the way. Cedric Brown gets his first carry of the ball game. He's a 236-pound sophomore from Flower, Texas.
You know, Keith, you're talking about Jerry Claiborne teaching that tackling. Carruthers is a coach's kid. He's fundamentally sound.
Offside, defense, 5 yards, previous spot, first down.
There's a look at Carruthers, the young freshman, 6'2", 190-pounder. This time last year, he was playing high school ball.
Second down, they need a yard. They run for it with the big guy rumbling. And Brown will go down to the 41-yard line for a Purdue first down. So the Boilermakers are moving the chains. There's your Aflac trivia question we asked you a while ago. Who kicked the winning extra point for Purdue in the 1967 Rose Bowl? Well, USC, the opposition, went for two. And George Katavalos intercepted the ball to stop the two-point conversion try. Bob Greasy, the quarterback, kicked the extra point. Now I want to tell you something as we come back to the field of play and the Huskies handle the running try. You saw Greece walk up there and smack that thing, and head came right up with it. Well, he took that same move right to the first tee.
Let me tell you something. Greasy was playing back when that was film. That stuff would bounce around. I was surprised they had face masks.
Happy New Year, Greece.
He's a good man.
Ball is on the 47-yard line where it is second down. Still 10, about 10 and a half for Purdue, and they go to the shotgun. With double wide, they've actually got three wide receivers up at the top of the screen. And put a fourth in motion. And Brees, getting pressure, knocks it off underneath. And he short-hopped it, didn't he?
That was well defended. You know, you're talking about Bob Greasy. Of course, when Bob was at Purdue, he set a lot of the records. But look how times have changed. Look how the passing game has come into football. I mean, just look at the yards. And I mean, look at all the school records and listen to the music. That's your kind of stuff, Keith.
Oh, yeah.
That's taking you back in time. That was Bob Greasy's music.
Strangers in the night.
That was the number one song that year, wasn't it?
Winchester Cathedral was a big hit that year, and so was Michelle.
Cathedral.
Third down and nine. Breeze getting some pressure. Passes away. Short hop that one. And avoided the sack. Rock Alexander, who has been in the ball game playing in the nickel package, and Rock making his presence known.
Just when it looked like Purdue was starting to gain some momentum here, the defense asserted itself. A couple of good hits by Carruthers and Akbar, and Triplett got in the act that time, and they stopped them.
Scott Kurz now, the punter, is into the ball game. Toure Butler is waiting for it.
This is the field position. You have to, if you're on defense, you have to watch for a fake.
Tim Stratton, the tight end, does the snapping. He's trying to hit it up the elevator shaft, and he's got it up there, and a fair catch is called. And now they throw the flag. They have to throw the flag. I mean, it has to. It's automatic, isn't it?
Well, there was contact, sure.
Yeah, it's contact.
Anytime there's contact like that on a fair catch, you've got to throw a flag.
Stratton, the man that snapped the ball.
Non-contact, kick-catching interference by the kicking team. Five yards from the spot. First down.
Who's contact made?
Hey, Jack.
But you know what? Even if that guy's coming forward, that receiver's coming forward to make that catch, you've got to give him the leeway. You've got to give him all the space to make that catch.
Well, Tim tried to avoid him, and his momentum just carried him right into it. So that's the end of that, too. Man, not happy with the circumstance. He's a gamer. does not like to trail. They trailed in that great month of October twice by 28-10 and came back to win both the games, one of them against Michigan.
Watch Tui Asisopo now work the rest of this clock in this half.
From the 21-yard line, first down, will hand the ball off to Willie Hurst. And Willie pops across the 25 to the 26, and we'll pop down to Todd.
Well, Keith, Marcus Tui Asisopo has a lot of the, as we should say, big uglies protecting him. One of them, Chad Ward, could be a world's strongest man candidate. He set a school record for a 733-pound squat, power clean 430, and a bench press of 500, just over my best. He has a vertical leap of 31 inches, and he is impressive. And these guys average 314 pounds in the front line, so the Royal Prince is in good shape.
I'll tell you what, that big old Elliot Silver's on the other side at 320 pounds, may be more agile, actually, than Chad is. But Chad straight ahead is a powerhouse. That was Pat Reddick making that catch.
Again, a high percentage pass, using the clock, moving the chains, got down, brings up third down and short, gives them several things they can do here on third and short. You can open up the playbook.
There's the comparison of the Washington offensive line against the Purdue defensive line. But so far, I don't really feel it's made all that much difference.
No, it hasn't.
Boilermakers have held their own very well. Third and short, Tui carries, and he looks like he will have it. Because the ACC officials do not look like they're doing that one step, left foot, right foot stuff.
No, and that's a good call, too. Anytime you have short yardage, whether it's on the goal line or the middle of the field, I've never agreed with taking a quarterback away from the mark that you have to get to hand off. Just let him go forward and get it. Just find the little gap right there.
Ball is precisely on the 32-yard hash mark now, where it's first down for the Huskies. You've got Conniff and Hurst and two-back set now for Washington. With three wideouts, and Tui Asisopo comes off. The snap changes the play, rolls it out. Nobody to throw it to, and it will go out of bounds.
You know, that's a mental mistake, Keith. He should have thrown it away. He was outside the 5 yards. Nobody was open. He should have thrown it away and not lose yardage.
Tomorrow night, the Bowl Championship Series goes down the road to New Orleans as the Miami Hurricanes and the Florida Gators will get after each other in the Nokia Sugar Bowl, live at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC, home of the Bowl Championship Series. Get complete analysis of all the BCS games, including announcer bowl predictions, at ESPN.com, keyword BCS.
Very rare to see Marcus make a mistake like that.
It's second down and 16. That's a good play by number 53, Sean Phillips, who batted the pass away. That is not a good series for Marcus Tui Asisopo.
No, it definitely is not. Phillips is one of those quick guys. He's a young guy, redshirt freshman. They say he could be one of the best they've ever had. Now watch this. He's 6'3". He's got a wingspan of about 8 feet. He gets up when he leaps. That's hard to throw over.
What he's in, he might be doing here, if he's not careful with 2 minutes to play, he might be giving Purdue not only good field position, but also momentum.
Well, give Purdue a lot of credit for what they're doing, but this is where Marcus usually shines. He melts that clock and moves the chains.
And he's got to do it on third and 16. They got a piece of him, and they take him down. It is Stuart Schweigert. He ran over Schweigert and when he scored his touchdown, but this time Schweigert won the skirmish and took him down. And so the Boilermakers will call a timeout now to possess the ball, forcing Washington into a punt. And the Boilermakers ought to come off this with pretty good field position. The score is 14-7 with 1:52 to go in the first half. And Fleming to get the ball away and get a lot of air under it and keep Donald Winston as far away from getting the ball in stride to give Purdue field position. So let's see whether or not Fleming can do all that. Washington punter is standing just inside his 10-yard line. Snap is good, and the kick is away, and it's not as high as he probably wanted, but a fair catch is called, and no flag. Purdue folks are hooting for a flag up around the 41-yard line as Rock Alexander bumped into it. Let's spend a moment now with John and Terry.
Well, Keith, coming up on the National Cardinal Halftime Report, four games already in the books today And Terry, in a couple of days, your dad will play for the national championship. But the week has not started out very well for the Bowdens. Your brother Tommy was a loser today.
Yeah, he was. You know, he played Michael Vick in Virginia Tech. You know, Michael Vick said he may come out after this game. Tommy's wishing he'd have come out last year.
You, by the way, for the second consecutive year, undefeated.
I'm
Keith,
there.
Back to you.
All right, John, did you call the corner? On first down from the 42, the ball is thrown to Vinny Sutherland on the sidelines, and just that quickly, you're across the 50 and down to the Washington 47 for a first down.
Washington got a big break on the punt. There should have been interference call because Rock Alexander came down and actually touched the receiver, hit the receiver, tried to tackle the receiver after he called fair catch. Now Breeze comes out with two timeouts, great field position. Purdue's in terrific shape here.
Call it the 48-yard line for the first down. Staying in the shotgun where he has more time and more vision and throws, and the receiver falls down. Vinny Sutherland lost his footing and goes down, incomplete forward pass, short hopped it. It's very hard. When you run across that rose out there in the middle of the field, it's like running across a sheet of ice. You tell your story.
Well,
it's a
here's the deal.
Story.
Here's the deal. You know, they had helicopters out here today trying to dry the paint on this field because the weather's been so good, the grass is growing through the paint, and had to repaint it. Bad part is, I sat here for 20 minutes today watching the paint dry.
We got to get you, buy you some books or something. Ball is thrown short underneath, completed to A.T. Simpson, and Simpson is wrestled down at about the 43-yard line. At least some crayons.
They had to keep repainting the field because they had to cut it because the grass was growing.
That's funny.
That helicopter driver was good, though. He was going up and down this football field.
We haven't had any rain around here in 3 months. Here it comes. Bang, that slant. Seth Morales got position in front of Von Tour and ate him up. And it's first down Purdue at the Washington 27-yard line. You cannot defend that play if you give that man that position.
Well, and they're protecting Breeze better. And Breeze is throwing on time. He's delivering on schedule. And you're right. Anytime you've got a good receiver out there that uses his body for positioning, they're going to complete it.
Breeze pass goes down the pipe, incomplete, and almost intercepted. Intended for John Standiford, and Rock Alexander had a chance to come away with that one.
Told you that this is a wide-open, fun offense. Tiller calls it basketball on grass, and they've got footballs flying all over the place. He loves this offense. It's fun for the kids. Boy, this one's almost picked off, though. Should have been a touchdown number one. Standiford lets it go right through his hands, but look at Alexander still fighting the ball and really had a chance to intercept it. He had to locate it, hit him up on the shoulder pad, and he couldn't get his arms up.
Second down and 10 from the 27. 53 seconds to play in the first half. 14-7 ball game. Drew Brees throwing for the end zone. And it's incomplete. Too high, too deep for Vinny Sutherland. He was defended by Chris Messi. Vinny Sutherland is a 5'10", 194-pound senior.
He's listed as 5'10", but I'll guarantee you he's not any more than 5'8 and a half, 5'9. I mean that. He's more like a Wayne Krivet type wide receiver.
Incidentally, you see two or three of the players, including Sutherland, wearing the hat with the plays on their wrist. I'm told that Drew Brees wears that armband with 100 plays.
Yeah, all numbered. The number. He knows what the number is. They call number five. He knows it.
Third down and 10. Going to play action. And throws to the sidelines to Sutherland for the first down. How good is that kind of stuff, huh? They had him spread out. The Huskers were trying to contain him. Would have preferred probably he run. Instead, Sutherland just hid down there on the sidelines and made the catch.
Well, he can run, but they know he can throw, and he's most dangerous when he throws. He puts that ball above his shoulder pad. You see the linebackers and the DBs break down. Now, all of a sudden, he finds his wide receiver and just puts it out there. He freezes him by bringing that ball up high, finds the receiver, and then locates it and lets that ball fly.
Massey dropped off of Sutherland and left him alone, and then he stopped on the sidelines. It's first down at the Washington 13. To the sidelines again he goes, and it is caught and taken out of bounds, stopping the clock at 37 seconds, and it was Chris James making that reception.
Believe it or not, folks, as much passing as they do at Purdue, it's a high-percentage offense. It's dink-and-dunk stuff. Drew Brees has it down to a rhythm. He throws on time, but they're all short passes for the most part, and very rarely does he go past his first or second read. He comes up, he looks at the defense, and by reading the defense, he knows which receiver will come free.
37 seconds to go in the first half. And the Boilermakers have it at the 9-yard line of Washington's second down. Brees pumps, throws, no. Intended for Sutherland.
And that wasn't a good pass, Keith, and Drew knows it. He's hitting his helmet right now because he knows he had a touchdown, and he just overthrew it. You know, earlier, Stanford dropped a touchdown, so they're having a tough time getting in the end zone. But watch, he knows this man was open, and he knows he overthrew him. That's just frustration from a great competitor. That's the one his granddaddy, who was a great coach, would be telling him about after the game.
Third down from the 9. Third and 6.
And a defensive man free. They had to cover him. Here he comes.
And the pass to the end zone is incomplete. Good coverage for the Huskies that time. Pass intended for A.T. Simpson. Omari Lowe was the man who made the play. And it was Hakeem Akbar that was chasing Drew Brees.
Brees saw him coming, too. He knew they overloaded to that side and outnumbered him. So he saw the uncovered man and went the opposite direction, saying Akbar's going to have to chase me. But that's good coverage and a good overload by Washington.
And this will get Travis Dortch into the ball game for John Shelburne's snap on the field goal try. The holder is Ben Smith. And it is a 26-yard try. Chip shot for Travis. It's good. So we've got 26 seconds remaining in this first half, and Purdue adds three more to make it a 14-10 ball game.
Alex is still being worked on.
Yeah, he took a lick on that
slant.
Line. He's really hurt.
Yeah.
Here's the kickoff now. Anderson. It's a short high one. It's fielded at the 15-yard line by Vinny Sutherland. Found a hole up the middle of the field. Gets to the outside. There's a penalty flag in his wake. And they finally bring him down. Inside the 40, down at the 35-yard line. And where's the flag?
Had a lot of penalties in the first half. 9 by Purdue, 4 by Washington.
Could be against the Huskies, you know that?
If it is, it's their 5th of the game.
Encroachment on the kickoff by the kicking team. That penalty is refused. First down.
So a big play with Vinny Sutherland, and here's Purdue crank it away. Bobby Hauk, the special teams coach for the Huskies, not happy with that.
Great return. Watch this now. His eyes immediately go to the right side where he sees a hole and sprints that way. Very little false steps, never. He's trying to get yardage everywhere he goes. When he outruns the kicker, he says, I better cut back to the inside, and that's the end of the run, but it was great decision on his part.
Purdue ball, Washington 36-yard line, first down. Brees turns and gives to Montrell Lowe. And Lowe will go down for perhaps a little loss on the play, but no more than the line of scrimmage.
Keith, that man right there was the story of the first half. Montrell Lowe, just 5'8", 16 carries, 71 yards, some of them spectacular. Watch this. His feet never touched the ground. He was the reason that Purdue was able to win the battle of time of possession by 5 minutes in the first half. Lowe with 71 exciting yards.
Call it second down and still about 10. Two wide at the top of the screen, two wide at the bottom. Not very many folks left in the middle. Brees throws quickly and it's almost picked off. It almost went to the hands of Rock Alexander, who had nothing between him and the goal line except cool late afternoons.
Well, I'll tell you what happened there, too. Washington went to dime defense. They had 5 defensive backs in the game at one time. Rock Alexander's looking at Brees the whole time and actually reads his eyes and goes that way. Tremendous step in by Rock Alexander, reading it all the way, and he almost had the pick.
Third down and 10. Working out of the shotgun. Drew Brees throws to the sidelines, completes the pass. They've done that 4 times today. Vinny Sutherland making the catch. They just go down the sideline and hide, and Huskies let him go.
We haven't seen Lowe since he had that helmet ripped off in that one tackle. Here you go right here as you look at Sutherland. He just runs a good out pattern, runs him off, See, Massey backed off, couldn't make the turn or the cut as quickly.
So Lowe's back in there. He started the half, second half. Ball is down on the 24-yard line. And it's a first down on the catch by Sutherland. Breeze keeps it. Wants to come back this way and does. And let's check in a moment with Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, the word on Montrell Lowe in that first half is we saw his face took a few licks. The helmet came off a couple times. They finally put a few stitches in his lip during the halftime. They are going to bring him back in. He will see more action throughout the day, so it's not going to stop him whatsoever. We're still checking on Rich Alexis, though. The doctor's still working on him.
Alrighty. That last pass was intended for Lowe, but he was well covered, and so Breeze just threw it away.
Go, Doug!
Just starting the second half. 17-10, Washington leading. Off of a 47-yard field goal by Anderson. Breeze on second down and 10, throws high into the air to the end zone. Touchdown, Benny Sutherland. Beautiful pass. Remember, Sutherland is only, I don't think, more than 5'9", for sure. And that ball was touched right into his hands perfectly. Rock Alexander and Greg Carruthers was there, and nothing they could do about it.
His second touchdown reception of the day. Drew Brees picked him out by reading the defense immediately. He was going to him all the way, never looked off. He ran a flag pattern, had the inside receiver, took that flag right to the post, and the ball was waiting for him. That was well thrown. Good route, too.
Travis Dorsch for the point. Out of Ben Smith's hold, and the kick is good. So we're tied at 17 with 11 minutes and 58 seconds to play in the third quarter.
Idle hands on the devil's playground. I'm going to let you go this time, but take it easy out there.
Internet helps you reach millions of customers around the globe. But who's keeping you in touch with the internet?
Fujitsu. The possibilities are infinite.
Hello, Mr. Buffo. Thank you for the nice gift pack of
beef jerky. Oh.
Beef jerky.
Thank you.
Well, Jeep, wish I could take credit, but I didn't send you all any jerky.
You didn't?
Well, no. The last gift I sent you was that box of filet mignons about 2 months ago. Y'all got that, didn't you?
Shipping internationally?
You're there?
This is a job for FedEx.
Hello?
The Rose Bowl, presented by AT&T. This ABC Sports exclusive brought to you by Dodge and nearly 3,000 dealers who invite you to come see what's different. FedEx, official sponsor of the Bowl Championship Series. Inspired technology with a human touch. Nokia, connecting people. And Dell.
Ball was maybe a foot too far in front of him. Very close. Elstrom is playing with a very sore knee.
He is, but again, Tuiasosopo goes to play action, and he locks on the receiver that he wants to go to. Actually had him open just a little bit too far out in front. But I can see what the Purdue guys are saying by saying, watch Tui's eyes, because he's leading you to the receiver that he's throwing to.
Second down and 10. Joe Tiller having a look. Stevens got at him by the shirt coattail and spun him around. Aiken Iadel gets the sack on Marcus Tuiasosopo.
Keith, you were right on top of that one, because in that situation, when they're second and long and third and long, we told you they like to go to Stevens. He's looking for him here, but watch this coverage. Turner's on him. Turner's got hands on him. Rides him hard. Stays in his hip pocket. Now comes up and jumps on his side. And there was no way that Tuiasosopo was going to throw into coverage down this deep in Purdue territory.
Ball is back on the 30-yard line, where it's third down and 17. to the original line of scrimmage. They might be within big old Andrew, John Anderson's range again. He nailed a 47-yarder. Is he coming? Yes, here he is.
And that one he hit from 47 could have been good from 57.
Yep. So, John, who is only a sophomore from Boynton Beach, Florida, he was partly responsible for Rich Alexis coming out, and there's some other people coming from Florida. John turned out to be a pretty good salesman. 42-yarder. Snap was a little high, but he got all of it.
Wow.
Big leg. Good. Huskies go back to the lead, 20-17, on a 42-yard field goal by John Anderson.
The interesting, Sutherland thought he was open again, and Lowe had that closing speed. Right here, it looks like Sutherland's open, but watch Lowe close, and that's one of the guys they wanted to attack. Talking to the coaches and talking to Tim Hundley, Jim Chaney, the offensive coordinator, says, hey, we're going to go at Lowe. We're going to take some shots at him. There's one of the shots. Lowe responded, broke it up nicely.
Second down and 10. Shotgun, Breeze quickly, sideline, good, out of bounds. Out of bounds at the 31-yard line, pick up 5 yards, Donald Winston. The attendance today, 94,392. 'Tis a fine gathering on a fine day.
And one of the greatest scenes in all of football.
Great venue. Third down and 5.
Breeze for the year, 58% on third down, the best in the nation.
Quickly, Sutherland, short of the first down. They didn't take him down on the first hit. He kept his feet, but they've stopped him 2 yards short of the first down. Akbar. Oh, did it?
Great stop by Washington.
Purdue will have to punt it away on 4th and 2. And Scott Kurtz is in the ball game. 45 and 29, his 2 punts so far today. Kim Stratton, the tight end, does the snapping. Do they have enough people on the line of scrimmage?
They do.
Low kick, tail dragger. Going to take a good roll for Purdue. Finally picked up by Butler back there, but he's immediately knocked down at the 13-yard line. He kicked it away from Butler, and it was a low line drive tail dragger, and when he hit the ground, it took off like a rocket. It turns out to be a big kick of 53 yards.
Give in to the big, tasty original chicken sandwich at Burger King. Right now, it's just 99 cents. Crispy, delicious, all white meat. With fries and drink, it's just $2.99. The original chicken sandwich, just 99 cents. With fries and drink, just $2.99. At these prices, we're practically giving it to you. Only at Burger King.
I don't care who started it. I want it to stop. Now.
Look, it's time you take things into your own hands.
The unification of corporate subsectors must be authorized.
Football, but I really love music.
Britney and LL Cool J host the American Music Awards next Monday, 8, 7 Central on ABC.
We'll be doing the play-by-play.
And as a result of the ball hitting the ground and rolling. Well, let's see what happens here. Who's in there at that deep back position? It's Alexis. Rich Alexis is in there, and he's coming right up the middle. No, it's Conniff, the fullback, coming right up the middle. First man out of the two-back set. Pat's going to pick up about 3-4 yards. Tomorrow night, Bowl Championship Series continues on ABC. The Miami Hurricanes, Florida Gators, Nokia Sugar Bowl. That'll be live at 8 Eastern, 5 Pacific on ABC, home of the Bowl Championship Series. Get complete analysis of all the BCS games, including announcer bowl predictions. Oh, that's a good deal. Announcer bowl predictions at ESPN.com. Keyword BCS. Did you vote? Kuyasa Sopo throwing into the crowd. Completes it to Joe Collier. Tight end, who makes his first catch of the day. Big target. Joe 6'7", 260 from Spokane.
You know, what's amazing to me is Tuiasa Sopo so mobile, and you look at everything he's done, and he's only a two-year starter. Pac-10 Offensive Player of the Year, holds 11 Washington records, 8 career fourth-quarter comebacks. He's only been a two-year starter. Talked to Gil Brandt, the great scout in the NFL. He says, hey, listen, mobile quarterbacks are big right now in the NFL. This guy's a warrior. He can play.
Option. Oh, he got around the corner. And Peck's favorite play, and got it to midfield and a first down for the Washington Huskies.
I think the only drawback would be on him, Keith, is he's a thick guy, and thick guys don't keep their speed as long as the more slender guys over the long haul. But right now, he's got terrific speed. He's got terrific strength. And look at the mobility he has, the fake, and then turn it up and look, get that extra yardage.
Money they're paying today, 5 years, you can go be a partner. Buy a fishing boat. Do whatever you want.
I'm with you.
First down from midfield for the Huskies. Option going the other way. Going to run a reverse. Here comes Butler. Oh, my goodness. There's a push in the back. It's Terry Tharps. Terry Tharps coming around. And the Huskies are going to lose it. He's had a big push in the back.
Holding.
Had both, and they had holding, and I saw the push in the back. But they had Elliot Silvers, a big old tackle, had come out here to be the lead block, and there was another block downfield that just destroyed the defender. And Tharps is blazing
holding
speed.
By the offense, 10 yards from the spot, repeat first down.
Question now is, where was the holding, and how much of a penalty is it? It'll be a 12-yard gain, a 10-yard penalty, so you got a first and eight, really.
But you know what? That Rick Neuheisel's got to be going crazy right now because he worked on that play all week in practice. He waited for just the right time where he thought he had Purdue pursuing and over-pursuing, and he came back with a reverse. It worked perfectly, and they get the penalty.
So it's first and eight with Willie Hurst in at tailback now for Washington. And Tuiasa Sopo's pass is away and is in the trap.
No. Skipped it.
Bounce pass in there, and a moment now with Todd Harris.
Well, Keith, it's amazing who you'll find on the Washington Husky sideline. Now with the Kansas City Chiefs, Warren Moon, and I know you got to be rooting for your dogs today.
No question about it. You know, this game brings back a lot of memories for me because it's where my career started, and I've been behind the program ever since I left. These guys are doing a great job.
What are your impressions? Evaluate number 11 for me.
Oh, he's a great player. You know, he's a playmaker. He doesn't have the greatest arm. He doesn't have the greatest size, but he makes plays and he wins, and that's what a quarterback's supposed to do.
Great to see you, Warren.
Thanks a lot. Happy New Year.
What a good player he was. What a good guy he is. The ball is at the 44-yard line now as they get it across. And it'll be third down and about five.
Designed play. Looked like it was a broken play, but it was designed for Marcus Tuiasa Sopo to take that thing off tackle behind two big blockers. It'll bring up third down and long. And again, we tell you, that's where they normally look for Stevens.
At the lunch yesterday, I saw big old Bob Schlarett. I'll tell you what, that one-eyed quarterback, back-to-back Rose Bowl MVPs, that's almost unheard of, but Bobby was. Third down and five. Got to hurry. Can't do it. You know what, he lost his footing. He got skating around out there on all that paint Tim was talking about. You let it dry too much. Because it is really slick when you run onto that Rose, and he lost his footing.
Well, I'll tell you something else, too. They are not letting Jeremy Stevens loose. They had two guys on him. He's up here at the top of your screen, 14, trying to release. Marcus never had any time. They pinched him hard, so he decided to run it, which was a wise thing to do. Still couldn't get free.
Landon Johnson's the one that messed up that play for Washington. Purdue outside guy on defense. Ryan Fleming punting. Pops it up in the air, high. Sutherland gets away from it, takes a bounce, and the bounce bounces, and it's going to roll dead at the Purdue 4-yard line. Well done, Mr. Fleming. Ruby's coming aboard now. Not much real estate at his back.
You look at this, he set almost every record you can imagine. These are pretty good numbers when you look at this. You go all the way down to the bottom to the total offense down there. What do we say that was? That's about 7 miles worth of total offense.
From the four. Be careful, country. Hands it off. Montrell Lowe skating around. We'll get about a yard on the carry before Anthony Kelly puts it away. Isn't Anthony Kelly the one that's going off to South Africa for advanced studies?
Yes, he is.
He's excited about that. He was a young man that didn't care much about all the classwork, but along the way and getting to where he is, some teacher lit his candle and he is absorbed with it. The 9-yard line. They'll give his progress to the 10. And again, it's Anthony Kelly. Here's Todd with more on this interesting young man.
Well, Keith, he's just an absolute delight of a kid. He'll take a leave following the game. He heads to South Africa on the 5th. He'll be back in March. Now, he got the Mary Gates Scholarship. If the name sounds familiar, it's Bill Gates' mother. She was a regent at the University of Washington. He's the first University of Washington athlete to get it. And get this, he was a partial qualifier out of high school. Rick Neuheisel says South Africa will never be the same.
Give a kid a chance, though. He can succeed.
That's right. Third down and 4. Out of the shotgun. Brees quickly to the sidelines, and they're short of the first down. I think.
It's going to be close.
It's close. That was John Standiford, who hasn't seen the ball all that much today. They're going to measure. Rock Alexander may have been a tad late getting there.
I think he got a pretty good mark. You watch this, and the ball's delivered on time, but he doesn't have time to turn because they close on him quickly. He's looking at that first down marker, and he's trying to get there, but a terrific hit by Alexander, who, by the way, is playing a great game. Came in as the dimebacker. Now he was playing so well, they're playing him more and more in the base defense.
He's another one of those precocious freshmen.
Got a good spot, and I still don't think he made it.
It is short.
Just short. It'll take some gizzard to go for it down there.
No, it's not a good call, Keith. Not in a close ball game like this with so much time left, and these being two fourth-quarter teams.
Look, Joe's been played at Montana State. And he's seen all the snowfalls along the whole Rocky Mountain range and evolved this offense. He isn't going to gamble here.
It would take Gizzard to go for it, but if he doesn't make it, they'll rip that Gizzard out.
I don't think he's going to.
No, no way.
If it was 1:05 to play in the game instead of 1:05 to play in the third quarter, that might be different.
Sure.
Scott Kearse. Standing right back around his goal line. No pressure. Good kick to midfield. Ball caught. No fair catch. And a penalty flag.
They were inside the halo again. That's the second time today they've been called inside that halo, and they're not giving him that 2 yards they have to give him.
Might have a face mask, too. Cody Pickett warming up on the sidelines because Marcus Tuiasosopo ran down the tunnel a moment ago.
Non-contact kick catching interference by the kicking team. 5 yards from the spot. First down.
That's third time now that they've done that today. There he goes with accompaniment. A trainer going into the clubhouse.
Kind of dragging that right arm, too. It's just hanging by his side.
Yep, and Cody Pickett, who has played very little this season. And here's Todd with more.
Well, Keith, initially they're saying it's the shoulder of Marcus Tuiasosopo that he injured. rolled up on it. They went in for precaution. They want to take a closer look at it. And I don't think they want to do it under the glare of the fans here. I know a lot of folks at Washington, when they saw him ran in, everyone had a big awe.
So the story on Cody Pickett now, as he comes onto the field to replace Marcus. He's from Caldwell, Idaho, 6'4", a freshman. He has 1 for 2.
He's a big kid. He's got pretty good vision. They say he's poised.
Well, Keith Gilbertson keeps telling us that he's a very good athlete and he can run the option play very well. But we have not seen him do it in combat.
Well, and I suspect that's what they're going to do. They're going to start running the football here. And depending on how badly Marcus Tuiasosopo is hurt, knowing Marcus, he's going to come back in the ballgame. But if that's his right shoulder, he may not be able to throw effectively. But he still can run. There's a look at Keith Gilbertson.
So here's Cody Pickett in the hot box now for the first time in the Rose Bowl. Dropped. The ball is dropped by Rich Alexis. So you got two freshmen handling the ball there, and they don't do a very good job of it.
Well, you mentioned that he's coming into a tight fit situation. He hasn't done it very often. As a matter of fact, Tuiasosopo has taken almost every snap in his career, all but 35 in 2 years. So the timing's a little bit off, although it looked like the handoff was there and probably should have been taken properly by Alexis.
Pickett barely shows up in the season review, to tell you the truth. Here's Cody's first pass. It's a beauty right on his hands and out of bounds at the 40-yard line. Todd Elstrom made the catch. Young fella from Puyallup. Here's the latest from Todd.
Well, here's the word from the trainer. I just talked and they took him in. It's a right AC sprain of, unfortunately, his throwing arm. They said it's not too bad, but they want to take a picture just to make sure they think he'll be back.
Well, Pickett's biggest role so far was against Washington State. He came in and engineered a 7-play, 27-yard drive for a touchdown.
Willie Hurst is the tailback right now. So he's thrown once. He's going to throw twice. Passes away, and it's caught. But it's going to be short of a first down. On third down and 6, he had to come back for the ball, Justin Robbins, and he's going to be a yard short of the first down.
Now, Washington will take a good look at this, because this is close enough to go for it. But you've got a field goal kicker that's got a strong leg and has been very accurate today. So Rick Neuheisel will look at this. He'll talk to his staff. They'll get some consulting, and he'll find out whether he should go for it.
We've done 3 of them. ABC Sports coverage of the Rose Bowl presented by AT&T comes after this message and the word from our ABC station.
Aj Caravan. They read the temperature around the driver, front passenger, and back passengers, and give each zone its own control. It's the only minivan that offers automatic 3-zone climate control, because some like it hot, some like it cool, and some just want in. Dodge Grand Caravan, the best minivan ever. Different.
The play on the field is being reviewed. I want further review. I need further review. The ruling on the field is that there is no ruling on the field.
Introducing new Ruffles potato chips, now with bigger, thicker ridges that are even better for dipping. Together with new Ruffles dip and new chip and dip kits, they keep you coming back for more.
On deeper introspection, we ask, what is possession? Can we truly ever possess anything?
Television's best-kept secret is about to be revealed.
Who is the mole?
The game begins Tuesday, January 9th on ABC.
The 260 horsepower CL Type S from Acura.
Yes? I'm here for your DLJ Direct upgrade.
Upgrade?
Where's your computer, please? You see, DLJ Direct is tapping into the strength of Credit Suisse First Boston to form CSFB Direct. Now you can invest online with more award-winning research, more global resources, and more IPOs.
Impressive. Will this take long?
Not at all. Enjoy the power, sir.
Introducing CSFB Direct, coming online January 15th.
No Mercy, tonight at 9 on ABC7.
High, does it with Stevens, and here he does it with Elstrom. It says go up and get it. It's a jump ball, and if a 6'3 guy can't outjump a 5'7 guy, shame on him.
And the extra point try now by John Anderson. And it's good. So it's a 27-17 ball game now as Marcus Tuiasosopo takes his team in for the touchdown. But he did what he had to do. It's an amazing thing what a surge of adrenaline can do.
Well, he was the only experienced receiver that Washington had coming into this season. And with his leadership, guys like Robbins and Reddick and even Hooks, those guys started to catch on, and this became a very dangerous ball club.
John Anderson will kick it off. Sutherland and Clapton are waiting. Lights are on at the Rose Bowl. Short, high kick. It is fielded well up the field, and it is Pete Lockheed. And he'll get up to about the 28-yard line. Now the FedEx game summary.
Well, you see where the score is right now, and the rushing belongs to Washington. Let me say this. The Rose Bowl winner has won the rushing battle in 24 of the last 27 games. And with that ability to run the football coming into this half, Washington 14 minutes, Purdue only 4 in time of possession, as you look at the rest of those numbers.
And now, Mr. Breeze, your stage. Very simple little stand-up play, but it works for pretty good yardage. Picked up about 8. Today's aerial coverage provided by AT&T. And there's the sun sliding gently into the Pacific.
These have been 5 of the most beautiful days I've ever seen in Southern California.
Don't tell anybody.
Clear as a bell. You can have all those Easterners moving out here. Midwestern. I may be one of them.
How? I have a question after this play. Under center, turns, penalty flag goes down, ball is handed off. Play stops just about the line of scrimmage. How much are you allowed to curl your offensive line?
Well, we've got Dave Perry up here. That's something that they cannot get off that offensive line. They have to be aligned with the other linemen. It can't be a yard off that line. They can't be 2 feet off that line. They've got to have a hand on that line of scrimmage, do they not? All right, so the helmet must be on the imaginary line. See, they can't cheat at all. And that's something Rick Neuheisel was talking to the officials about before the ball game to watch for.
There have been a couple of times it looked like a semicircle.
Well, that's illegal. They won't always call it, but Rick Neuheisel was trying to alert them to it.
They picked up the first down.
There's your offensive line. You can see their helmet's supposed to be on that line of scrimmage.
Breeze down there, and it is incomplete. He had it on the hands of his receiver, Standiford, but John was in some traffic and couldn't reel it in. Ben Madavi was the man covering on the play for the Huskies, and now Drew Breeze is going to be looking at second down and 10.
This ball was thrown so well right a little bit behind right it, but I mean right where only his guy, John Standiford, could get it. That ball has to be caught.
The thing that amazes me about him in traffic like that, with the sky falling on him, he's able to put touch on it. Ball is not thrown hard. Very catchable.
Surprising to me is the tight end Stratton, only 2 catches in the game.
He's been very quiet. And 3 wide outs at the top go back the other way. The pass is completed, and it's a big gain for Purdue as Cedric Brown came out of the backfield. They had 3 wide receivers up the top of the picture to the left, came back to the right to the fullback, and got a big play out of it.
Brown's one of those guys. He plays mostly on the third down team. You know, they come in packages. Certain guys have certain roles on this team, and Brown's is usually on long yardage, and they just kind of slid him out of the backfield. I don't think anybody even knew.
Huskies were nobody over there.
That he was back there because the linebacker never did pick him up.
Nope. It's a first down for the Boilermakers at the Washington 37-yard line. Here's a running play with Lowe fumbling the football, and Washington says they've got it.
I think they do. That's the first turnover of the ball game. The first turnover of the ball game.
Lowe took a wicked hit from Greg Carruthers.
And he's still down. Brothers covers the ball. And I'm not sure that Greg had a piece of the hit or not. But it was a slashing blow. And we've got a timeout for the injury. So the ball is turned over by Purdue as they're trying to get it in the end zone and shorten that 10-point lead. It is Carruthers that hit him. So Washington gets the ball back at their own 34-yard line. And Tuiasosoko options down to Willie Hurst. And Hurst got around the corner. Willie and Alexis both have the speed to turn that corner on the option, and Willie just did it there. It's first down, move the chain. The time remaining, 10 minutes and 46 seconds in the ball game. Washington is leading 27-17.
Keith, at halftime we told you that Purdue dominated time of possession, and you can see that. Look at the second half. Washington 14-08 to just 5-06 for Purdue. It's a game of keep away. They're keeping Drew Brees on the sideline.
On the 47 for this snap. And it's Hurst. Oh, Willie's motor's running. He's inside the 40-yard line, down to the 38. Again, I say to you, you've got 5 300-plus pounders along the offensive front, and they've been beating on them all day long, and it's getting now into the middle of the fourth quarter.
And how many times, Keith, have you heard out here about the Pac-10 being a wine and cheese conference, being soft, especially last year? I don't think so anymore, especially Washington. This is a very strong, physical football team.
First down at the Purdue 38-yard line. Pat Cunniff gets a carry. And the big fullback from Woodinville is inside the 35. It's a gain of about 4 yards. 94,392 came. The Purdue folks all went over to Universal City last night and almost wholly occupied it. They've had a good time. I haven't run into anybody from Indiana that hasn't had a good time out here this week.
Both schools. Yeah. Both schools. Well represented.
Well behaved people. Just terrific.
Play clock down to one. He's not going to get it off.
So you got second down and 6 coming up after this timeout with 9 minutes, 11 seconds to play in the game.
Nokia Mobile Internet. Nokia, connecting people.
Well, the baby is looking healthy. How are you two doing?
We're great.
Just doing the parenthood thing, you know, buying a minivan.
Oh?
Oh, he's kicking.
What minivan?
The Odyssey?
Mm-hmm. Nice. Very nice.
With a fold-down third-row seat, a 5-star safety rating. It's beyond the minivan. The Odyssey from Honda.
You wouldn't believe the sales.
I hope you didn't put all those in the credit card.
Yeah, why?
Those interest charges are really gonna get us.
Don't worry. I used our new Capital One card. It's interest free.
To the neighbor! Capital One card, all your purchases would be interest-free until July 2001.
We gotta tell Bob and Carol about Capital One.
What's in your wallet?
The Nokia Sugar Bowl, as much a part of college football as ABC Sports. Miami faces Florida tomorrow night at 8, 5 Pacific.
Four different players, plus 2 field goals from John Anderson. Clemen had a touchdown. And Tuiasosopo had a touchdown. Willie Hurst has had one, and Todd Elsworth one. Anderson kicks off. Low skittering thing. It's caught on by the up man again. That's the second time that Lockheed has made the reception
up around the 30-yard line.
Keith, let's go back to the Dell Game Solutions. You can see the total play advantage. Let me break this down very simply for you. When Purdue has more plays than the opponent, they normally win. And when they don't, they've lost. Today, they've had six less plays, but here in the second half, Washington has run 37 plays to just 15 for Purdue.
Let me say to you, folks, this thing, it ain't over. Like Yogi warned you, it ain't over till it's over. There's 7 minutes and 17 seconds. And if anybody can get it done in a hurry, this is the guy right here. And Reese throws complete to A.T. Simpson, and he's right on the first down marker. As we go along in the game, I would like to say that the gentlemen from the Atlantic Coast Conference have done a fine job officiating this ball game. The referee, Jack Childress, and his crew are an outstanding job. Reese looking to go big. Now gets a little bit of heat. Finally chased out of the pocket. He's got all day, and he has to throw. And they say no. Never had control of it. Sutherland went out of bounds. Ball wiggling around in his hand.
Saw some of Drew Brees' escapability there, though. He has that internal feel. He knows when people are coming. He's got an instinct to know. And he got outside the pocket and rolled, but here's what you're talking about, not having possession. See him bobbling the ball as he goes out of bounds.
He went to his left and still really put something on it, put some heat on the ball. He's not a gimme, I'll tell you. He's 6'1", 220. You're not going to get him for nothing. Second down and 10. Reese throws to the sidelines, and the pass is caught. And again, it's just short of the first down marker.
Told you about the ability of both of these teams to be strong in the fourth quarter. Well, Purdue had to come from behind. And here's, I know that this really impressed you. I mean, these are some of their comebacks.
That's just remarkable.
These are some of the comebacks they had. And look how they won late.
Yeah, but look who they're playing.
I know it. How about the October they had?
Oh, wow. That really is impressive.
But they can come from behind, and it's because, like you said, Drew Brees just has a gun.
Third down and one. Throwing to the first down. It's not good. Bounced off the shoulders of Cedric Brown.
I'm not sure he would have made it had he made the catch, but, you know, Drew Brees is going to lead a comeback. He's got to get some help. They've had a lot of drop balls in this ballgame.
Fourth and one, and they're going. There's no question about this. Defending here is Omari Lowe and Jamon Willis.
That ball still has to be caught.
So here's a fourth and one call.
This is the ball
game. 41. 6:47 to play. This baby is wrapped in the best tinsel. It's a run. It's good for the first down. And he isn't through yet. He scores. Touchdown, Purdue. Cedric Brown refused to give up on the sideline, just kept pumping, and the Huskies could never get him out of bounds.
And you know who threw a key block? Drew Brees. It wasn't a great block, and it wasn't a block that would knock a guy off his feet, but he was out there scrambling just enough to keep him off his running back. Now watch, here's the handoff. Keep an eye on 15 come around and try to help Brown out. Now watch, Drew Brees, 15, diving over right here, the running back trying to readjust and getting just enough to get him off his feet and let Brown come around the corner. I'm not sure he didn't step on the line.
No, I don't think he did. No, I think he was in all the way. The kick is in the middle of the uprights and good. Like I said, Yogi's right. Yogi's always been right.
AT&T's broadband technology, you can download a full-length ARIA to a home PC in seconds. That was Wagner's Die Meistersinger, the dance mix.
Trouble? It's Miller from Risk Management. He's in distress.
Miller. Monty, what's our capacity?
Well, headroom 38.5 inches, legroom 42.1 inches, and of course, shoulder room.
Mister, I need hip room.
Front seat or rear seat?
Rear seat.
A full 54.1 inches, sir.
That's more than enough. Got room for one more? Climb aboard, Miller.
It's easy to get carried away. The Accord from Honda.
NYPD Blue takes possession of Tuesdays, January 9th on ABC.
Sure do. Offensive coordinator's Jim Chaney, and he ought to go on the road. He's a funny guy.
I said, how difficult is your offense to learn? He says, if a rock had lips, he can tell you how it plays.
Reese quickly again over the middle. The ball goes almost intercepted. Oh, that wasn't a very good decision either.
Look
you
who it is.
Almost, yeah, Larry Triplett.
They were in a zone blitz. That means Triplett dumps out of there. Breeze wasn't expecting to see Big Triplett, the nose tackle, drop out of there. Here he is right here. Watch, he's going to come back like this. You know, Triplett's 295 pounds. Watch him move. Contact, drop back, almost had the interception. Still chasing him.
Well, they've doubled Larry most of the day.
They sure have.
Handled it. They've kept it pretty quiet.
First team All-American. He'll be playing on Sundays. Quality player.
Third down and 10. He may go soon, but he's going to think about it after this game's over. Bruce pass. He is over the head of the receiver. Incomplete. They're looking at fourth and 10. Omari Lowe defending against Vinny Sutherland. Lowe's a little bit bigger, 205 and 6 feet.
I'd go for the field goal here, Keith. You need 10 points. It's 10 yards for a first. The percentages aren't in your favor. Get out there, get the field goal, come back and get the touchdown later.
El Dorch is out there. I'll tell you what, this fella wearing that black hat there, pretty crafty. He knows what he's doing.
It's all down to game management now, time management.
Ben Smith holding, John Sheldon snapping. 6 foot, 6 inch place kicker. Out of leg. And no good. He missed it.
Wow.
Oh, my. The ebb and flow of the last few minutes of this football game has been incredible.
Can't imagine the feeling. Your heart must sink when you get everything you can into this thing, and you're watching it and sailing left, and you're saying just hang on, and it goes left by about 2 yards, and then watch Rick Neuheisel on the other side. Yes, sir, it's going left. He's a golfer. He knows how those things drift.
And so the Huskies hold the Boilermakers to the sidelines. The offense pondering what might have been. The defense on the field bone tired but fighting till their last gasp. And here's Washington's offense. First down from the 25. Time remaining now is 4 minutes and 54 seconds. And this is Rich Alexis running for a first down over the 35 to the 36-yard line. The freshman from Florida may have a sore shoulder, but I'll tell you what, he's playing tough. Coming up right after we get through here will be the Tostitos Fiesta Bowl as Oregon State and Notre Dame have at it. Another of the bowl championship series, first time those two teams have ever met. Oregon State lost only one time. That was up in Seattle, and they watched a field goal stay wide right by about 3 feet. That would have forced a tie in that game.
Most speed the Irish have seen all year.
Oh, yeah. And here is Alexis bouncing off the pile and coming to the outside and getting to the 40-yard line. He's got 4 yards on the play, where he probably should have been dropped for a loss.
After Tuiasosopo turned the ball over in the last offensive position for the possession, Rick Neuheisel, I'm sure, got that offense together and said, hey, look, guys, be smart. Here's the biggest game of your lives. All you have to do now is hold on to the football. We'll get out of here with a win. Very, probably unusual. It's going to be rare if you see Tuiasosopo throw a pass the rest of the way.
Alexis has 9 carries since he got going in the second half for 77 yards.
He's dipping that shoulder and going strong at him, too.
Second down and 6. This time there's only a yard. Here's Todd.
Well, Keith, Coach Rick Neuheisel does not eat before games, even when it's an evening game. I don't know if it goes back to when he was a player here. He came to the Rose Bowl sick as a dog with food poisoning. He walked down the tunnel. He came separate from the team. His dad said, what's wrong? He said, Dad, I'm sick. I got food poisoning. His dad said, so what? This is the biggest game of your life. Get in there. Rick said he went in the field, never felt sick again.
We've got 3 minutes and 27 seconds to play in the football game. Washington fighting to hold on at 34-24. Willie Hurst is the tailback. Ball is handed off to the fullback, Pat Conniff. And Conniff
bangs his way to the 45, and he is 1 yard short of the first down.
Tui Asisopo wants to go for the first. I think I'd punt it away, but he's got Rick Neuheisel's attention.
I don't think I would.
I would definitely not, but Tui Asisopo says he wants to go for it. Rick Neuheisel's leaving him on the field.
I don't see a punter out there.
Nope. He had called the punting team up, and Tui Asisopo looked to the side and said, we've got to go for it. And Rick told those guys to back off. He's got
6 seconds left on the play clock. So what they're going to do is spend the timeout or take the penalty. They're going to take the timeout and talk about it. And I know that there's a lot of Husky faithful wringing their hands and shouting and pleading and begging to punt it.
Well, the punting team's coming back up to Neuheisel.
At least make them go the long way. But with the presence of Drew Brees, you know, a long field doesn't mean that much. And here comes Ryan Fleming, I think.
I still haven't seen him. Jeremy Stevens comes in. He's usually your...
Yep. Fiesta Bowl with Oregon State and Notre Dame. They're coming up right after we get through. And remember that it was Washington that inflicted the only loss on the Oregon State Beavers up in Seattle. That's the field goal try that was wide right. With the Huskers leading 33-30, that's the only game the Beavers lost this year. Notre Dame had a remarkable error-free season for them. So few turnovers. Very, very efficient football team.
About 5 yards right of an undefeated season.
Yep. I think that's going to be a terrific football game.
How about this club right here beat Miami? And Miami's down there saying, hey, look, we beat Florida State. We ought to be number one. But this club right here at 10-1, having beaten Miami's got a claim to something.
All right, it's 4th and 1, and here comes a big old... I mean, this is showing some grit, folks. He keeps it. He's got it. He's got a first down at midfield, and this time he didn't pitch it. That ought to be your ball game. Well, I'll tell you what, I remember a long time ago, maybe 1967 at the Gator Bowl down in Jacksonville, when Joe Paterno went on a play similar to that in the middle of the field. Florida State came back and beat him. Ron Sellers and that bunch.
Tell you this about Marcus Tui Asisopo. He is talented, he is exciting, and sometimes erratic. But what a big play player.
So on first down at midfield and the clock running now at 2:10, that may very well have been the ball game. If the Huskies don't turn it over, that play is good for about 3 yards. And I want to do some credits here. Executive producer of ABC Sports is Howard Katz. Executive producer college football, John Filippelli. Director of production, Bob Toms. Coordinating producer, Bob Goodrich. The guys I've worked with all season, and I think they're wonderful. Producer Mark Loomis, Patrick McManus is our director, John Zippe, our technical director, associate producer Derek Mobley, associate director is Jeff Kibler, technical manager Dennis Zabo, production manager Joe Alvarado, our assistant to the producer Jason Trevico, Tom Wicks, statistician Mark Amento, Kelly Hayes, Mark and Kelly our spotter, and Mark and Kelly having just come back from the NFL playoffs, computer stats Brian Shiroto and Freddie Amos. Our stage manager, Dave Henner. I've been doing college football for 48 seasons, and I don't know that I've ever enjoyed one more than this year.
I'll tell you this, partner, it's been fun for me, too, and Happy New Year to you. Thanks for everything this season.
Timmy Brandt and Todd Harris pleasantly working the sidelines today. No snow, no ice, and no heat. And a good job.
Purdue takes that timeout, Keith, and they've got one remaining. Mentioned, it is a high hill to climb now.
For Joe Taylor's staff, Ken Green, Mark Hagan, Greg Olson, Scott Downing, Brock Speck, Jim Cheney, we mentioned, Danny Hope, Kevin Sumlin, Gary Emanuel. Brought an entertaining, interesting football team to the Rose Bowl. Had a good time, and this is Willie Hurst running to the outside. And a big ball game for Willie, coming home to perform. And he's picked up another first down for Washington. And for the Washington Huskies, Rick Neuheisel's staff, Keith Gilbertson and Tim Hundley, Chuck Heater, Steve Axman, Brent Myers, Randy Hart, Wayne Moses, Bobby Hawk, and Tom Williams, another outstanding coaching job. Going to go 11-1. This is a team winning this ball game today, that will finish the season 11-1, and they beat the Miami Hurricanes. So we could have a split championship. I mean, the Associated Press is not committed to the BCS poll. The coaches poll is. And this is Willie Hurst bouncing around again and picking up a couple of yards.
Minute and a half left, and of course they're still running as hard as they possibly can, melting that clock and getting out of here with their Rose Bowl championship. Very, very disappointing game for Purdue. But if you look at the quarterback comparison, and certainly they were the guys that everybody was talking to coming in or talking about coming into this ball game. Terrific game by both of these quarterbacks. You see the minus 25 down here, though. Two sacks. He was tackled two other times for big losses when he was trying to scramble. Both of the quality guys that will be playing on Sunday. Matter of fact, Gil Brandt, Keith, told me that he thinks Drew Brees is the same as Peyton Manning on a 3-inch shirt.
Well, Brees and Manning spent some time together. I guess Peyton, in some sense, has become sort of a mentor for young Brees. Clock ticking along now, 35 seconds, and now it's a matter of just running it out. And the flashbulbs are popping, and Rick Neuheisel has been drenched, and he was trying to avoid it, but he had no chance. They had him right in their sights and nailed him.
Yeah, but you know, that bath there is not nearly as hard to take as those ones when it is frigid and snowing like it was last night down in Louisiana.
And you know what? There's a guy back in Indiana, Mark Burrell, who's watching tonight, had watched a good football game, and he's got his health back, and he's one of the happiest guys in the world. We'll return with the new Ford Escape post-game show after this message. 34-24 for Washington.